the call, and we'll give you a tow.
Welcome to Championship Wrestling, a full hour packed with the world's most exciting wrestling events.
The art of wrestling is as old as man.
And you too can make a very special friend for life.
Your news, 1 hour earlier. Fox 17 News at 9. Your first look at the evening's top local and national stories. Plus tomorrow's weather forecast from a Fox 17 weather team. Get your news 1 hour earlier than any other local newscast. Watch Fox 17 News at 9.
Do you yearn for the days of yesteryear? A time where the law was in your own hands.
Robbery is one of the things we like to watch on account of there ain't much else to do.
Watch The Andy Griffith Show tonight at 10 and 10:30 on UPN 30.
Got you pinned for the 1-2-3. You need to come see my friends at Mufflers, Brakes, and More. Come see my friend Robert and the gang, where they specialize in mufflers, brakes, and any of your other car repair needs. Don't wrestle with them old car problems. Bring them down here to my friends, Mufflers, Brakes, and More.
The classic monster movie returns.
We must all try to avoid panic.
When Gamera battles a mysterious foe bent on destroying Japan.
Gao stands 210 feet high and weighs 25 tons.
If you loved King Kong and Godzilla,
you've got to expect imminent disaster.
Then you don't want to miss the original creature feature. Return of the Giant Monsters.
Watch today at 2 on UPN 30.
Does your car not want to go? Well, don't worry, we can tow. Here at Brown's Automotive, we specialize in light, medium, and heavy towing. There's no car or truck too hard for us to handle. Our specially trained staff is on call 24 hours a day, and our quick response time makes us one of the best in Nashville. So when your car doesn't want to go, just give us a call, and we'll give you a tow.
Why? What a couple of behemoths going to tie up next on USA Wrestling. Scott Hudson and Jim Cornette, and into the ring, the massive Leviathan.
Wait a minute, no, we got a couple of behemoths in the ring. We got one behemoth that is the demon of the deep, the guardian of the gates of hell, the right hand of Satan himself, Leviathan, managed by wrestling's perfect 10 sin. And then you got Fat Albert without the Cosby kids. You talk about, I'm going to tell you something. You know anything about NASA?
Of course.
I have it under good authority that the space shuttle just sent back the first known photos of the north side of this guy's waistline.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
He's rolling. So fat when he goes to McDonald's, the sign changes.
Oh, that's...
He's so fat when he goes to a restaurant, they give him an estimate.
That's plenty of
He's
that.
He's so fat, he doesn't order a steak, rare, medium, or well done. He said, knock the horns off and bring it out on a leash.
Now, see,
that's how fat he is.
That's enough. Rolling Thunder, a veteran of these ring wars, and Leviathan. Oh, man! He took 521 pounds down with a back elbow. Good night, what a monster.
Leviathan is a monster. Leviathan is a demon. Wait a minute. It should be a foregone conclusion. No, Leviathan's not finished with him yet. Sin raised him. Sin raised him from the depths of the ocean. He is the guardian of the gates of hell. He crossed the river Styx to come to USA Championship Wrestling and destroy anybody in his path.
Look at Rolling Thunder.
Oh, look at Rolling Thunder. What is he doing? Trying to commit suicide?
Oh, man!
Kevorkian was booked. He's got to do it this way.
A stiff
Come
kick.
On.
Right in the face, and Rolling Thunder at 521, Leviathan.
Oh, whoa.
Somehow. How on earth did Thunder roll?
Rolling Thunder rolled all right. As a matter of fact, he's got to flap his arms so you can tell whether he's rolling or walking.
Oh, come on.
But wait a minute. Now, Leviathan takes a right, barely faces him. There's another one. This guy's got some weight behind his punches. That's about all I'll give him.
Leviathan.
Wait a minute.
Oh!
There's that spear. There's the demon spear. And
good God, it's over. And Sin, the perfect 10, has found an incredible monster in Leviathan. Rolling Thunder. Well, the storm's over.
Well, exactly. Rolling Thunder rolled, and there ain't no more lightning.
Get caught up on all the latest pro wrestling news. It's the USA Championship Wrestling Hotline, 860-7000. That's right, 860-7000. Call right now. Get all the latest gossip, all the latest news, all the latest local action, 860-7000. Call every day, updated all the time, USA Championship Wrestling. If you really want to know what's going on in the world of professional wrestling, this is the number you need to know, 615-860-7000.
How you doing, wrestling fan? Your old buddy Bert Prentice here with you with another great 90 minutes of wrestling action. As I sat back last week and saw that enormous crowd for the 6th annual Tojo Yamamoto Memorial Card, I reflected on my past 15 years here in the Tennessee area. And you know, ladies and gentlemen, there's one man who's been here almost 30 years, who's beat them all, who's headlined all over the place, and has actually made Nashville wrestling famous. And I think he deserves some recognition. So tonight, we're going to salute the king of wrestling, the real king of professional wrestling, Jerry the King Lawler. We're going to give him a Lifetime Achievement Award. I've invited his family and closest friends. Jerry Lawler knows nothing about this happening. It's going to be all a surprise tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. We want you to come out and help celebrate the career of Jerry the King Lawler. It's going to be incredible because I know Lawler, and when we get him in that ring and give him this award, and we're going to do a little history on Jerry the King Lawler tonight. Folks, be a part of that. It's going to be special. And on top of that, we're going to show you a segment here in a minute, what happened at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds last week when David Flair won the Tojo Cup. That's right. Flair wins the Battle Royal, and who but Jerry the King Lawler has to come save him when the giant Leviathan and Jim Cornette pull a Shanghai on young David Flair. That's why we have the big match tonight. Flair and Lawler on the same team against Leviathan and Cornette. And folks, I got something special for you too. When you buy your ticket tonight, you'll be given a green card. That number on that card is your special lucky number. Everybody gets one tonight when you buy a ticket at the box office. If we draw your number, you're going to go not only to the pay-per-view on May 19th at Gaylord Entertainment Center, presented by the World Wrestling Federation. I'm so excited I can't talk. But we're going to pick you up at your house in a limousine. and you and three of your closest friends or family members can go in the limousine. We're going to take you down to the Hilton, where you'll meet up with Jerry the King Lawler. And you all are going to go to Eddie George's club and have the meal of your life. And after that, go across the street to the Gaylord Entertainment Center for the pay-per-view, all on USA Championship Wrestling. That's right. A limo is going to come to your house to pick you up, take you to meet Lawler. You're going to have lunch with Lawler, and then the pay-per-view. Over $1,000 worth of prizes tonight, the Tennessee State Fairgrounds, and all you got to do is have the lucky number. Some lucky fan's going to win all that tonight at the fairgrounds. So when you buy your ticket, make sure you get your lucky green number. All that tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds as we honor the king. You want to make a reservation? Call me right now at 366-8036. Operators are standing by. If you want ringside seats, there's no increase in prices. It worked out last week. We sold out in 20 minutes. Thank you very much, Nashville. We love you. If you want that ringside seat this week, call right now, 366-8036, and reserve your ringside seat tickets. If you don't get a live operator, leave your message on the message machine, and we'll pull your tickets. Well, it's all going to happen tonight, and let's see right now why and how did we get to this main event. Who would have called this? Jerry Lawler, David Flair, Leviathan, and Jim Cornette. This is how it all came about. We started with 25. Three remain. Leviathan, David Flair, Jerry the King Lawler going for the first Tojo Cup and $25,000. Flair and Leviathan. Flair grabs Jerry the King Lawler. Lawler ducks and Leviathan knocks David Flair's head off. My gosh, and now the King is firing up on the giant Leviathan. We're down to three. Jerry Lawler, Leviathan, and David Flair. Lawler got Leviathan reeling on the ropes. Flair still on the other side of the ring, reeling from Leviathan, knocking his head off. And Lawler's got Leviathan draped over the top rope. Here comes Flair behind Lawler and dumps them both over the top. And David Flair has just won the first Tojo Cup. David Flair has just won $25,000. Cornette is furious. Cornette on the outside is furious, asking, what the hell are you doing? You and Leviathan are a team. Cornette is absolutely furious. Sid is furious. Why did you dump Leviathan? Cornette is out of his mind furious. Oh, my gosh, I'm glad you're not sitting ringside. Cornette, I'm telling you, Flair's getting a cussing in the ring. Cornette says, we got a deal. Cornette is furious with David Flair. Here I come in the ring to give David.
The people at home, congratulations. The winner of the first Tojo Cup, $25,000 that you can go redeem it. There you go, buddy. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir. I really appreciate it.
David Flair, ladies and
gentlemen. $25,000 in that. Watch it, Cornette. This is a family show as Leviathan comes from behind on David Flair. Leviathan, oh my gosh, is just pummeling Flair. What in the world? Picking up that big choke slam. Oh my gosh. The force sends Leviathan in the air. Leviathan has now grabbed the $25,000 check. Now Cornette has it. Leviathan now picking him up. Oh, my gosh, just dropped him right through the mat. Cornette hands Leviathan the check, and he rips it up. Leviathan now sticking in the mouth of David Flair. Cornette is out of his mind with rage. Oh, my gosh. I'm sure you heard Cornette as he just punches the daylight out of David Cornette. We need some help out here. But I don't know who's going to come save him. Cornette now stringing David Flair up. And that evil witch Sin now just slapping it. Oh, my gosh. Slapping him so hard, one of her rings flew off into the third row. Now Cornette and Leviathan both kicking the daylights out of David Flair. Someone's got to come help this young man. He just won the Battle Royal. He's been trying to make a name for himself. Oh, there's Lawler. And Cornette goes a flying. Now Lawler confronts the big man.
injured just like a statue. Lawler and Leviathan face off. Leviathan is a monster as Cornette pulls him through the rope. Cornette says, let's do this on another day. Lawler there, Lawler bloody from the temple, bloody at the knuckles. Lawler comes in the ring to help an injured David Flair. Cornette's in. Don't worry, Lawler, I'm going to turn him loose on you next. Lawler now checking on David Flair.
Let me say this. I think everybody has probably seen the verbal jabs that have gone back and forth between me and David's father, Ric Flair. I'll be the first one to tell you, I'm not a huge Ric Flair fan, never have been. And that's mainly because Ric Flair and I were always at our prime at just about the same time. And we both had a little bit of an ego. And I always personally thought that I was a little bit better than Ric Flair, and I'm sure Ric Flair always thought that he was a little bit better than me. But the truth of the matter is, whether I liked Ric Flair or not didn't really matter. I always knew, as well as everybody else did, that Ric Flair was without a doubt one of the greatest wrestlers that has ever stepped foot in any ring anywhere. And it's always a very difficult task for somebody to try to follow in somebody else's footsteps. It's a long, hard road, especially when those footsteps are as big as the ones that David's dad left. And I realize that all David wants to do at this point in time is to follow in his dad's footsteps and have his dad be proud of him. And I want to tell you this, that we tried as hard as we possibly could to put together the match between myself, Brian Christopher, David Flair, and Ric Flair. And we had hoped that match would have taken place tonight, but the truth of the matter is, and I respect the man for this, Ric Flair said that he don't want to be looked at as the guy that has to come and take up for his son. He wants his son to become his own man. He wants his son to learn how to stand on his own two feet. And the way that you do that in this business is getting your butt kicked night in and night out until you're finally tired of getting your butt kicked, and you stand up, like Rick said, on your own two feet, and you start kicking butts. And that's what I think that David Flair is ready to do. And David, I don't have one thing against you personally. Well, I don't. So I'll just say this. Congratulations on your win tonight. I'm sure that you winning this battle royal is going to make your father proud. And I was not about to stand by, and your father wouldn't have stood by and watched three jerks like that jump on anybody. So if you want a tag team match, if those guys want a tag team match, if you want a partner, I'll be more than glad to do it. It's not any big love for David Flair. It's not any big friendship there. It's just the fact that from day one, I have hated Jim Cornette's guts. And this big freak show that he's walking around with here tonight, he needs a lesson. He needs to learn why they've called me the king for the past 30 years. So if you want the match, if you people want to see the match, I'll be more than glad to be a part of the match.
April 6th, 2002. That's tonight. A salute to the king, Jerry the King Lawler. Join all his friends and family as we salute the career of Jerry the King Lawler tonight. And he has no idea what's coming at the Tennessee State Fairground tonight. You'll also see John Saxon take on Seven. Chase Stevens collide against Jason Riley. Kevin Northcutt returns to take on Elix Skipper. Chris Cage and Jason Jeter take on Me Incorporated with Ernest T. It's a loser leaves town match when the Tennessee Cowboy James Storm collides against Ashley Hudson. Air Paris takes on Corey Williams. For the North American title match, Chris Harris versus Prince Justice. Woo, somebody stop me and look at this main event. Jerry the King Lawler and David Flair on the same team taking on James E. Cornette and the giant Leviathan with Sin. It's all going to happen tonight. It's the salute to the king tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. Be a part of history tonight.
Another thing that's going to be very special tonight, fans, the first 100 people in line at 5 o'clock. That's the first 100 people in line at the fairgrounds tonight, not the first 100 tickets sold, but the first 100 people who are actually standing in line will receive this gorgeous color 8x10 picture of Jerry the King Lawler, all helping celebrate tonight, Jerry King Lawler night at the wrestling matches. If you're one of the first 100 people in line at the fairgrounds, box office opens at 5 o'clock. We're going to come in the line and give you a free picture of the king tonight.
Who you calling a freak show, Lawler? By the time we get through with you, all you're going to be fit for is a sideshow.
You know what ticks me off? You know what ticks me off? Ungrateful people. You know what ticks me off? People who are not appreciative when something is done for them. You know what really gets my goat? David Flair, who I took from obscurity, who I plucked from nothing and taught him everything he knows. Sure, his father's nature boy, Ric Flair. Obviously, the seed did not plant correctly. Obviously, the genes didn't transpire because David Flair, you're nothing but a whiny crybaby. I made you, David Flair. I brought you to USA Championship Wrestling. I built you up to be the next icon of wrestling. And what do? You stab me in the back. You can't do the job right. And just like all these rednecks around Tennessee know, when you don't do your job, you don't get paid, you get fired, you get docked, sometimes you get your butt whipped. And that's what happened right here in Nashville at the fairgrounds. So now, what have they done? Burt Prentice, in his infinite wisdom, has decided one tag team match involving Jim Cornette wasn't enough. One time screwing Jim Cornette around wasn't enough. So now we're going to do it twice. But you see, this time I've got the last laugh. Because last time it was me and David Flair, an unappreciative crybaby, in a tag team match against Jerry Lawler and Brian Christopher. The odds were not even. I'm not a wrestler. I'm a manager. But this time, oh, this time, tonight, right here in Nashville, right at the fairgrounds, it's going to be different because it's going to be Jerry the King Lawler, the guy that you just can't get rid of, like fungus on a shower curtain. He keeps coming back. It's going to be Jerry Lawler and that unappreciative, wet behind the ears, crybaby David Flair. But the opposition on the other side of the ring is going to be a little bit different because you see, Jim Cornette is not even going to have to step in the ring. Even though I'm more of a man than you people realize, even though I have biceps the size of most people's heads, I'm not going to get in the ring. Why? Because I've made a deal with Sin, Satan's cheerleader, the Wicked Witch of Kentuckiana. And I have obtained the services of the most fearsome, physically dominant, intimidating, frightening visage that the world of professional wrestling has ever seen. 6'7", 320 pounds, the guardian of the gates of hell, the right hand of Satan himself, the demon of the deep, Leviathan. Jerry Lawler, your myth will come to an end tonight. David Flair, your career will come to a premature end tonight because at the fairgrounds, you're going down at the hands of Jim Cornette and Sin and Leviathan.
Oh, what a big night it's going to be tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. Somebody's going to win a limousine trip to the Gaylord Entertainment Center and the World Wrestling Federation pay-per-view, plus lunch with Jerry the King Lawler. Most importantly, though, come tonight and help Jerry Lawler celebrate his entire career, his entire Nashville wrestling heritage, tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. Folks, you're not going to want to miss it. Besides the great matches, loser leave town match, James Storm against Ashley Hudson, Elix Skipper returns, Cage and Jeter, the giant Prince Justice, something for everybody tonight. And what about that main event? David Flair, Jerry the King Lawler on the same team on the same night. And you know Jim Cornette's going to try to ruin the whole evening for Lawler. And the greatest thing about this, ladies and gentlemen, Jerry Lawler has no idea this is going to happen. We've kept it low-key all week. It's been a major secret. Of course, he's in Memphis this morning. He's not seeing our TV show. So when he drives up to the building, he has no idea what's going to hit him at the fairgrounds tonight. It's the King Night in Tennessee. The King Night at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. Fans, come on out. Show Lawler your support. Help Jerry Lawler. And you know what? Come just to show your appreciation, how much he's meant to you over the years. And I know that there are Jerry Lawler fans all over the area. And he's going to be overwhelmed. It's just going to be a great, when I start thinking about it, I'm telling you, I get goosebumps because it's just going to be one of those special nights at the fairgrounds. Help us celebrate the King tonight in Nashville.
Before we get started, Mr. Lawler, I'd like to do one thing. I'd like to apologize to you and to all the people here in Nashville. You know, I've acted like a jerk lately, you know, and I'm sure I didn't make any fans by acting like a jerk. And you know what? You know, my dad's probably ashamed of me by the way I've been acting. You know, I should have never listened to Jim Cornette. And I want to apologize to you, Mr. Lawler.
Well, David, let me say this. I mean, I don't expect any apology from you. And it's true. I mean, you have not made many friends here in Nashville. But I think you learned last week that some people are willing to be your friend no matter how you act. To set an example. And you're right about another thing. You've been listening to and following the leadership of a guy that I've known for many, many years to be a first-class jerk. You just found it out last week. And that's one of the great things about learning this business, and it's one of the great things about learning lessons in life. And you learned a valuable lesson last week.
Sure,
but
sure.
Lessons don't come at, you know, they don't come free. They come at a cost. And this Jim Cornette, and this, whatever she is, Sind, and this monster, this Leviathan, these guys are intent on exacting even more of a cost from you, and now from you and I. So what we're going to do tonight, right here in Nashville, Tennessee, we're going to let Jim Cornette and the whole freak show that he seems to surround himself with, we're going to teach them a little lesson. We're going to let them go to school tonight. We're going to let them learn, first of all, why for the past about 30 years here in Nashville, Tennessee, they've called me the King. And we're going to let them learn exactly what the man that is the son of probably one of the greatest wrestlers that ever stepped foot in the ring, and I'm talking about Ric Flair, the man that is Ric Flair's son, they're going to learn exactly what he's capable of. Now, I want you to promise me one thing tonight, David. I want you to promise me that you're not going to worry about tonight making fans. You're not going to worry about winning friends. I want you to do one thing out there tonight. I want you to go in that ring as my partner with the intention of hurting people. I want you to go out there and I want you to hurt Jim Cornette. And I want you, if it's possible, to hurt Leviathan. And if that little sleazy tramp that he calls Sin gets in the ring, we're going to have her get hurt too. So that's all I'm asking you. And then tonight, Cornette, like I said, it's go to school time. And you've been around a long time. And you're real good at picking up on a fresh freak like this Leviathan. And that's how you keep hanging on, Cornette. You always grab onto somebody's coattails, and they keep dragging you along. Well, now it's Leviathan, and he's dragging you along. Well, I'm going to tell you something. We're going to cut those coattails tonight. And Leviathan, yes, you're big. You're bad. And as just I've said before, you got muscles in places we don't even have places. But I'm going to tell you this. We're not scared of you, and you're going to find that out tonight.
All you dog lovers out there, listen up. Nomad Kennels in Murfreesboro, Tennessee is teaming up with Petland Pet Store in Murfreesboro to offer basic, intermediate, and advanced training of your special friends. Dogs are a lot of hard work. Call Nomad today. Nomad also trains and sells and contracts out detection dogs to police, fire departments, security agencies worldwide, school districts, and private businesses too. We offer private classes for your convenience. Train with the people who train the professionals. 615-573-6243.
Before you do this, your transmission. Breathe in to Affordable Transmission and Auto Center. We're the affordable solution for all your auto care needs.
They're the pride of Murfreesboro, Tennessee.
affordable transmission for all your car care needs. 494-0141.
Bring it in to Affordable Transmission and Auto Center. We're the affordable solution for all your auto care needs.
Dealer quality. That's affordable.
I want to take a moment to thank all of you in Tennessee for making Direct the fastest growing car insurance company in the Southeast. With offices across the state open 6 days a week, we'll take care of you at Direct. So give us a call and get your auto and life insurance from us. We're Direct, the big local company that appreciates your business. Car insurance the Direct way. Car insurance the Tennessee way.
Save a lot of money when you buy Direct.
Scott Hudson and Jim Cornette on USA Wrestling, and Jim, we are supposed to have, now, finally, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant, back where he may, wait a second.
Oh, wait a minute.
Ernest T. just got his oil changed by the man from New York City.
Well, Ernest T. was just trying to give his man, Mike Rapata, some last-minute instructions.
Oh, let him go. Mike
for
Rapata.
For heaven's sake.
Rapata, let him go. I want to see Ernest T. what he could do with the Boogie Man.
I don't want to see what Ernest T could do with a boogeyman.
Oh,
I don't.
Well,
really.
I know you've got issues with Jimmy Valiant that go back a long, long time.
Well, I've got a lot of issues with Jimmy Valiant. He has beaten many of the men that I've managed over my career. But I still don't want to see Ernest T and Jimmy Valiant in any kind of confrontation. Ernest T's a manager, for heaven's sake.
Oh, you call that a manager?
Well, he manages to manage.
He barely manages that. Mike Rapata, former NWA World Heavyweight Champion, and Jimmy Valiant. Boy, how many titles has Jimmy Valiant held? Former Worldwide Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion, United States Heavyweight Champion in the NWA. He's
he was
them all.
The Southern Heavyweight Champion at least a dozen times, Southern Tag Team Champion. He's in the WWF and the WCW Hall of Fame.
Absolutely.
Of course, the WCW Hall of Fame was a short list.
What is that supposed to mean? I resent that.
No, you resemble that.
Oh, I'm sorry. I misspoke. Oh, now Ernest T is begging Rapata to get a shot at the Boogeyman. Didn't the bell ring? I heard the bell ring. Why isn't the match starting?
Well, the match hasn't started because Jimmy Valiant, trying to throw Mike Rapata off, is castigating.
He's who?
He's castigating Mike Rapata's manager.
Well, he'll clean it up. All right, the Boogeyman planting the referee high atop the corner, and we're going to get Ernest T and the Boogie. Here we go. Look at Ernest T. Oh, no.
Oh, no, he's got him by the honker.
No, that's the nose, actually. Oh, look at this. Into the rear mount. Oh, and Ernest T. Into the safe, sheltering arms of Mike Rapata of Me, Inc.
Jimmy Valiant knows that he can't take Mike Rapata. Jimmy Valiant's a legend, but unfortunately, he's in the twilight of his career. Mike Rapata is the man around here today, and I think Jimmy Valiant is playing psychological mind games. Unfortunately, Ernest T has no tools.
I beg your pardon. That's a little more information than I wanted to know about Ernest T. I got to tell you that. All right, finally. Have we got enough TV time left? Where's the producer? We're going to go. Connor and Evo tie-up. Rapata has Boogie. Oh, no.
Uh-oh.
Boogie Woogie Man stepped out of it, and Jimmy Valiant hadn't missed a step.
What do you mean he hadn't missed a step?
He looks as good now as he ever did.
How could you miss a step? You put one foot in front of the other, for God's sake.
But Ernest T can't do that.
Oh, come on. Ernest, I believe Ernest T, if he'd stay there and follow his strategy, I believe Mike Rapata can take Jimmy Valiant and beat a legend right here.
Oh, well, Mike Rapata, I'm not going to sell Mike Rapata short. Former NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Oh, the old finger right in the eye.
Now, how scientific is that? Jimmy Valiant not noted for his scientific wrestling.
Well, there you go. You answered your own question. What do you expect to see, like drop toe holes and side headlocks and hammer locks and float overs and escapes from Jimmy Valiant, for Pete's sake?
What are you reciting, Gordon Solie's autobiography?
I was reading that earlier today.
Now, wait a minute. Was the referee trying to check Mike Rapata's hand like Mike Rapata would stoop so low as to carry something into the ring?
Well, he carried Ernest T into the ring. It doesn't get any lower than that.
I said something, not someone.
Well, I rest my case. Watch Rapata in the corner. Rapata, I think, hang on a second. wrapping a chain around his fist.
No, no.
Well, of course he was. It was out of camera range.
I think it was his car keys. He forgot to take his car keys out of his pocket before he came to the match.
His pocket? He's got pockets in his tights?
They got wonderful things in these new model trunks.
New models? Now look at the Boogie Woogie Man. Now watch Rapata. Finally, look at this. There's Rapata wrapping up. Now he gave the chain to Ernest T. Attached it to his wallet.
Well, like I said, he brought his car keys in. He forgot he had them. He didn't want to wrestle with them in his tights, so he gave them to Ernest T.
Now, the referee actually assumed that Rapata hit a chain in his mouth? Oh, watch it. There you saw it. Ernest T giving the chain back. Oh, and now he's got it wrapped around the throat
of the
Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant. Come on.
No, that's a carotid clutch. He's clamping down on the carotid artery.
A carotid clutch?
That's correct.
Rapata had a chain wrapped around the throat of the boy from New York City, the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Valiant.
Mike Rapata clamped down on both sides of Jimmy Valiant's neck.
Oh, he did
not. Cut the flow of blood off.
He most certainly did not. He wrapped the chain. He's still got a chain around his neck. Come on. Get in there, referee.
Ernest T just back from his trapping expedition to Montana.
What?
Looks better than ever. He caught quite a bit of fur and at least one or two beaver while he was up there.
Oh, I'm not exploring that any further.
You wouldn't explore a beaver?
Not one that had anything to do with Ernest T.
They're amazing animals. They build dams.
Yeah.
They chew logs. They block up water so that they can have colonies. It's amazing.
Colostomies?
Saw it on the Discovery Channel.
Is it colostomies?
Colonies.
Oh, I'm getting my mic fixed.
You should get your head fixed.
Now, Mike Rapata, I'll give Rapata credit. You have to outthink someone like Jimmy Valiant. He's seen it all, and Rapata may have thrown a new monkey wrench into the works of the Boogeyman here tonight. Into the corner goes Valiant. Rapata.
Whoa,
look at that.
Holy mackerel, wait a minute. Over the top, is that legal?
Of course it is.
Shouldn't that be a disqualification?
Only if he lands on Ernest T.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Back body drop from Valiant and Rapata high, high into the air, and he hit with a thud here on this hardwood floor.
That shouldn't even be remotely legal.
It is barely remotely legal.
Well, Jimmy Valiant now getting a moment of respite.
He needed it for having the life choked out of him by that chain of Mike Rapata.
Well, Rapata was doing something illegal, but Valiant did as well. Now look at Valiant.
Oh,
won't even let the man in the ring.
Uh-oh, going to give him the grand tour. Rapata, oh, into the other turnbuckle. Watch Valiant.
Whoa.
Yeah.
He brought him in, but that was the hard way.
Jimmy Valiant is ready to put the finishing touches on Rapata. Oh, what a right hand. Valiant, oh, that right hand staggering Rapata. Backs him into the corner.
Oh, wait a minute now.
Oh, he's
the referee getting in between them.
What is Ernest T doing?
He was trying to get the referee to get Valiant off Rapata.
He most certainly was not. He was giving that chain back to Rapata.
Whoa!
The chain wrapped around the fist of Rapata.
Oh, he got him.
That's a tragedy.
Ladies and gentlemen, you have seen a legend upset here tonight.
Oh, I'm getting upset right now. Rapata wrapped a chain around his hand. And the former NWA World Heavyweight Champion. Look at Valiant.
Who is the new legend? He's a new legend.
Oh, no, no. There's only one living legend. But Jimmy Valiant is unconscious from that chain shot of Mike Rapata.
As well he should be.
That idiot Ernest T. Oh, this is disgusting.
April 6th, 2002. That's tonight. A salute to the king, Jerry the King Lawler. Join all his friends and family as we salute the career of Jerry the King Lawler tonight. And he has no idea what's coming at the Tennessee State Fairground tonight. You'll also see John Saxon take on Seven. Chase Stevens collide against Jason Briley. Kevin Northcutt returns to take on Elix Skipper. Chris Cage and Jason Jeter take on Me Incorporated with Ernest T. It's a loser leaves town match when the Tennessee Cowboy James Storm collides against Ashley Hudson. Air Paris takes on Corey Williams. For the North American title match, Chris Harris versus Prince Justice. Will somebody stop me? And look at this main event. Jerry the King Lawler and David Flair on the same
E. Cornette and the giant Leviathan with Sin. It's all going to happen tonight. It's the salute to the king tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. Be a part of history tonight.
Growing up in Ripley, Tennessee, everyone knew my dad. He was the mayor, founder of the bank.
Morning, Mr. Durham.
Good morning, ma'am.
And the lawyer anybody could count on for help.
They deserve justice.
To Dad, nothing was more important than a person's dignity.
Thank you, Mr. Durham, for what you've done.
I grew up to be a lawyer, too. I became a federal prosecutor in Tennessee. But my heart was in helping people the way Dad did.
I want to make sure you get the help you need.
So for more than 25 years, I've had my own practice helping injured people.
Got some good news for you.
And now Blair has become our family's third generation of lawyers.
I wish Granddad could see this.
I think he can, son. I think he can. These are good people, and they deserve justice.
I feel as if Dad's with me every time I fight for a person's rights. And if Dad is watching somehow, I just hope I've made him proud.
Call attorney Bart Durham, 242-9000.
Justice is your right, and we demand it.
If you loved King Kong and Godzilla,
we must all try to avoid panic,
then you don't want to miss Return of the Giant Monsters.
Watch today at 2.
He said nothing would happen to him. He promised.
A police officer killed by one of his own.
Who's going to turn them in?
The pretender joins the force to expose killer cops.
Killed him with armor-piercing shells.
Next pretender.
I go. You go.
Watch today at 4 on UPN 30.
Does your car not want to go? Well, don't worry, we can tow. Here at Brown's Automotive, we specialize in light, medium, and heavy towing. There's no car or truck too hard for us to handle. Our specially trained staff is on call 24 hours a day, and our quick response time makes us one of the best in Nashville. So when your car doesn't want to go, just give us a call, and we'll give you a tow.
Hey, folks, I want to say just a special congratulations to some of the winners who won the year pass to USA Wrestling and who are going to the pay-per-view at Gaylord Entertainment Center. Who won last week? Larry Lawson from Antioch, Tennessee. Dylan Reese from Franklin, Kentucky. Chris Howard from right here in Nashville. Kyle C. Bull from Nashville. Jackie Minnis from Lebanon, Tennessee. And Jamie Seeley from Big Rock, Tennessee. That's just some of the winners of the year pass last week. The fairgrounds, congratulations to all you great winners. Tonight, you know, we're giving away a limousine trip to the Gaylord, lunch with Lawler. It's Jerry the King Lawler night, something for everybody. Who's going to be the big winners tonight? Show up at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. What a night of hot wrestling action. Going to be incredible. We hope you join us tonight, only in Nashville.
Zbyszko and Taylor taking on the hotshot. Zbyszko with, for my money, the stolen North American Heavyweight Championship.
Well, fortunately, you don't have any money. He has the North American Heavyweight Championship belt, and he's also a living legend.
He is that.
And he's also quicker than a hiccup with the foot speed and the hand speed of his martial arts expertise.
What?
What?
Zbyszko has...
What is this, an Austin interview? I say it loud enough, you ought to be able to hear it first.
What?
You gonna do when Zbyszko runs wild over you?
Boy, about to hurl by Zbyszko. Hang on, hold page one. Zbyszko is stalling and avoiding a lockup.
All part of the strategy of the master.
He is a living legend.
He is a chess master, and this is physical chess.
Cassidy Riley. I don't think Cassidy Riley was born when Zbyszko got his start in wrestling.
And you know what? I'm pretty sorry Cassidy Riley was born to begin with.
Oh, now see, that's ridiculous.
No, that's unfortunate.
Standing hammerlock.
It's Planned Parenthood is what it is. It should have been.
Nice reversal escape. Oh, and Zbyszko going to take the easy way out. Is that the way they taught him at Penn State?
Let me ask you a question. You got a choice. You got the easy way. You got the hard way. How many people are going to take the hard way for anything?
I think you've got the easy way and the manly way. And he took the easy way.
Hey, everything manly doesn't have to be hard.
That's what she said.
What are you talking about?
Collar and elbow tie upside the headlock by Cassidy Riley.
Take the hard way instead of the easy way. Boy, into
the ropes.
You're one of those ones that does the long form on your taxes, right?
Actually, I do. Oh, sunset flip. rolls him up. Oh, and Zbyszko barely kicked out it. Oh, now he's going to pull the tights.
Well, he had the trunks.
Oh, he most certainly did not. Larry Zbyszko, no one would touch Larry Zbyszko's tights.
Why would a legend have to lie?
That's a great question.
Why would a legend want to lie?
Ask Zbyszko. Quick tag made to Terry Taylor.
And boy, Jits, you talk about getting from one place to another. Terry Taylor is a master of that ring. He knows exactly where he is at all times. Right now he's down. Right now he's
sunset
up.
Sunset flip.
He's up. He's down.
Cassidy Riley rolls him up in a two count that time on Terry Taylor. And Cassidy Riley, another pull of the tights.
Riley is a guy who likes to stick his hand in other men's trunks trying to gain a leverage advantage.
Pitifully inaccurate.
Well, all I know is Taylor knows exactly where he is in the ring. When he's down, he knows it. When he's up, he knows it.
But he just doesn't know if someone's pulling his tights.
Wouldn't you know if somebody's hand was in your pants?
Absolutely.
Well, so does he.
Hey, watch it. Back over to the wrong part of town. Oh, look at this. Oh, man, he's trying to wrench that shoulder right out of joint. Look at the glee on Zbyszko's face.
He's taking incredible glee.
Cassidy Riley.
See, he was trying to dislocate that shoulder, jerking right out of the socket. I'll tell you what, Zbyszko and Taylor are a well-oiled tag team. They work together just like the inner workings of a fine Swiss watch.
What is that supposed to mean?
It's supposed to mean their teamwork is intricate and flawless.
Well, it's supposed to mean that. Oh, wait a second. Here we go again. Now Zbyszko going to... Oh, come on. They're just trying to wrench that shoulder of Cassidy Riley just right out of its socket. Look at Zbyszko's face.
He's a sadist. He enjoys inflicting pain on another human being. Well, if you can call Riley a human being.
Well, of course he's a human being. One half of the Hot Shots, the hottest team in USA Wrestling.
They couldn't be hot if you poured gasoline on them and set them on fire.
Watch it. Don't say that kind of stuff. Never know who might be listening.
What are you going to do, report me to Human Resources? You don't work for WCW anymore.
Wait a minute. That's right. Who do I tell? Terry Taylor, wrist lock on Cassidy Riley. Oh, and Chase Stevens has had it. He wants to have a go at this. Oh, yeah. Here we go again. Hang on a minute.
Oh, my God.
Zbyszko.
Oh, my God.
He doesn't know that's Taylor. Wait a minute. Oh, the best laid plans of mice and men often go astray. Zbyszko and Taylor.
Thundercord was trying to tell him, but Zbyszko was so wrapped up in the glee of the moment.
Oh, Zbyszko has a lot of splaining to do to Terry Taylor if and when Taylor gets up from this arm bar of Cassidy Riley.
Well, that was totally unfair.
Why was that unfair?
Riley should have informed the man that he was jerking his own partner because, for heaven's sake, that's not sportsmanlike.
Arm bar.
To jerk your own tag team partner instead of your opponent.
I'm not going there, Jim. I'm not touching that one.
Well, I should hope you wouldn't leave it to the wrestlers of the ring. Now, wait a minute. Taylor's upset.
Here we go.
Taylor is not happy.
Well, of course he's not. Zbyszko almost wrenched his shoulder out of socket. It's his own partner.
I must admit it was a rather bad mistake to make.
Now Zbyszko laying him in high and tight on Cassidy Riley has been in the entire time here.
Hold on!
That's Zbyszko's arm. Taylor doesn't know. Look at Taylor's face. He's enjoying every minute of that.
You know, I'm not real sure. Wait a minute. I'm not real sure Taylor didn't know that.
I think you may be onto
Taylor's
something.
Taylor's acting like he didn't know it.
Well, he's not a good actor.
But
there are problems now between Zbyszko and Taylor. Oh, look at Cassidy Riley directing traffic.
Oh yeah, he's a little disturber.
Oh, of course he is.
He's an instigator.
Did somebody say party? Well, if you're in Wilson County, there's only one place where everybody goes to party. The Thirsty Turtle in Lebanon, Tennessee. And folks, how many times have you heard, sorry, the kitchen's closed? Well, at the Thirsty Turtle, not only can you drink and dance all night long, the kitchen stays open till they close. The Thirsty Turtle in Lebanon, Tennessee. Party!
Get caught up on all the latest pro wrestling news. It's the USA Championship Wrestling Hotline, 860-7000. That's right, 860-7000. Call right now. Get all the latest gossip, all the latest news, all the latest local action, 860-7000. Call every day. Updated all the time, USA Championship Wrestling. If you really want to know what's going on in the world of professional wrestling, this is the number you need to know, 615-860-7000.
One day your phone service is running okay. The next day it comes to a complete stop. Don't fret. Phone Reconnect of America can get your phone running again. And if you stay around, their rates will go down, down, down. Not up, up, up. Call Phone Reconnect of America. There's no deposit, no credit check, and there are no hidden charges. Phone Reconnect of America can get your phone running again. Call Phone Reconnect of America.
He's a skip tracer.
Bounty hunter, huh?
It's Nash Bridges versus his biggest rival. May the best man win.
You touch Getz, and I will throw you in jail.
Guess what I got that you don't got?
Well, it's not brains, we know that.
Bridges!
Nash Bridges.
Today at 5 on UPN 30.
Some of my favorite Jeopardy moments are when we play host to kids and teenagers. You really make me feel inadequate.
Sorry about that.
Tonight at 6 on UPN 30.
His name is Thundercourt. And I'll have you know that his great-great-great-great-granddaddy on his uncle's side, Apache Bull Thundercourt,
what?
Would have really been ticked off.
Apache
to hear you
Bull Thundercourt.
Knocking the great Apache nation.
I'm not knocking any nation at all.
The country was stolen from them, stolen from Derek Thundercourt's people by the evil white man like you.
Like me? I'm only 37. Wait a minute.
Hey, you look worse.
In there. Oh, but now the referee. There was a tag made, and the referee didn't see it. Meanwhile, as Chase Stevens distracts the official, Zbyszko and Taylor putting the boots to Cassidy Riley. Lateral press. Now, finally, the distraction by Stevens doing some good for his partner.
I'm daring this referee to turn around.
That's an 11 count, but only a 2 count. That counts.
The referee wasn't out of position. He was out of consciousness. He was out of his mind. He was out of touch with reality.
Rear chin lock on Cassidy Riley by Terry Taylor. And the veteran team of Terry Taylor and Larry Zbyszko. Zbyszko, the living legend, the North American heavyweight champion.
And Terry Taylor right here in this area. He's been a many times Southern heavyweight champion, Southern tag team champion, Mid-America champion. You name the championship in the last 20 years in this part of the country, Terry Taylor has held it.
Oh, I agree. What a resume. What a pedigree that man has.
No, you're right talking about Helmsley now.
No, I'm not. Please give that a rest.
Wait a minute.
You have Double T in the ring who just put a double forearm blow right across the upper back of Cassidy Riley. Meanwhile, Zbyszko.
You know, I like the way Zbyszko tells the referee to shut up without even giving him the dignity of looking in his direction.
Why should he? He's a living legend.
And well, why should he? Because the referee's an imbecile.
Oh, he most certainly is not.
But most USA wrestling referees are imbeciles.
There is not a bad one in the lot.
Well, no, there's none in the lot because they're all in the locker room. The cars are in the lot. The referees are in the locker room.
Maybe I didn't make myself clear.
Well,
hang on, lateral press. Only a 2 count.
Actually, you're
Riley.
As fuzzy as you normally are, Scott, but the point is that Zbyszko and Taylor still have control of this situation.
Front face lock from Zbyszko on Cassidy Riley. Riley trying to bull his way back into the corner to make the tag to Chase Stevens. It will be an entirely new match.
Wait a minute. Well, the referee having to caution Terry Taylor.
Oh, it's because Taylor was distracting the official purposely in case there was a tag made.
Oh, no.
Perfectly Riley. Executed suplex on Zbyszko. His back can't take that.
How do you know what his back can take?
Well, look at him. He took a suplex and he's not up yet. Cassidy Riley.
He'll be up before it's over with. He'll be up before Riley makes the tag. There, the tag to Taylor.
Riley's up. Can he make the tag? Taylor, the legal man. He made the tag. Here comes Chase Stevens opening up on Terry Taylor. Right hands just tattooing Taylor. Shoots him in. Big. Knee to the face. Quick press. No, only a 2 count on Taylor, but Stevens right back on it. Right hand. Shoots him across. Waits on him. Big back body drop. Down goes Taylor. And Chase Stevens with the right hands. Up flying on Taylor. Reversal. Stevens into the ropes. Taylor, right into the breadbasket. Stevens, the scissor kick into the back of the head. Is that it? Hooks the far leg to Zbyszko.
Oh, wait a minute. Now Riley all over Zbyszko. And Taylor, I bet he wishes he was someplace else.
All four men in the ring, two on two. Riley and Zbyszko in this corner. Stevens and Taylor in the far corner. The Hot Shots and the veterans doing some damage here on USA Wrestling.
And Thunder Court's trying to tear his hair out of his head. Wait a minute, Zbyszko and Taylor turning the tables. They've switched.
Double reversal.
Whoa!
Taylor and Zbyszko meet head up in the center of the ring. What a right hand.
Wait a minute, Riley just went out over the top courtesy of Zbyszko.
Zbyszko with the back body drop sent Riley to the floor. And Taylor, the go behind on Stevens. Oh, Stevens just hung out.
Oh, man! Straight right cross to the jaw of Taylor.
Standing Zbyszko side missed. Kick. Shoots Zbyszko outside. The five-star from Riley. He pinned him.
I can't believe this. I cannot believe it. You talk about upsets. You talk about upsets. You talk about Spinks beating Ali. This is even bigger than that.
Cassidy Riley pinned Terry Taylor. And there is going to be more dissension in the ranks between Taylor and Zbyszko. Zbyszko, cold cock Taylor in the center ring, and the Hot Shots come away with the Duke.
I'm Joey Styles. Vince McMahon and the WWF don't want you to know what I know. I have secret sources inside the WWF locker room and inside the WWF offices. I have all the news that you're not supposed to know. Plus, all the news on your favorite local wrestling promotions. Call the number on your screen now.
It's been called America's favorite fundraiser, professional wrestling. For all you nonprofit organizations, volunteer fire departments, Lions Club, JCs, if you need to raise money, call right now, 615-366-8036. Direct from Nashville, Tennessee. Big time pro wrestling means big profits. Look at this packed gymnasium. Call us right now, 615-366-8036, and we'll bring wrestling to you.
Does your car not want to go? Well, don't worry, we can tow. Here at Brown's Automotive, we specialize in light, medium, and heavy towing. There's no car or truck too hard for us to handle. Our specially trained staff is on call 24 hours a day, and our quick response time makes us one of the best in Nashville. So when your car doesn't want to go, just give us a call, and we'll give you a tow.
Big fun.
Celebrity guests.
An Emmy Award-winning host.
And an Academy Award-winning actress.
Watch tonight at 6:30 on UPN 30. Your news 1 hour earlier. Fox 17 News at 9. Breaking news and live reports on America's fight against terrorism and how it affects you. Your first look at the evening's top local and national stories. Get your news 1 hour earlier than any other local newscast. Watch Fox 17 News at 9.
April 6, 2002. That's tonight. A salute to the King, Jerry the King Lawler. Join all his friends and family as we salute the career of Jerry the King Lawler tonight. And he has no idea what's coming at the Tennessee State Fairground tonight. You'll also see John Saxon take on Seven. Chase Stevens collide against Jason Briley. Kevin Northcutt returns to take on Elix Skipper. Chris Cage and Jason Jeter take on Me Incorporated with Ernest T. It's a loser leaves town match when the Tennessee Cowboy James Storm collides against Ashley Hudson. Air Paris takes on Corey Williams. For the North American title match, Chris Harris versus Prince Justice. Woo, somebody stop me and look at this main event. Jerry the King Lawler and David Flair on the same team taking on James E. Cornette and the giant Leviathan with Sin. It's all going to happen tonight. It's the salute to the King. Tonight at the Tennessee State Fairgrounds. Be a part of history. Tonight.
UPN 30 reminds you to set your clocks forward 1 hour tonight.
If If you need money to get a car, CNAC Financial